Now I'm going to show you how to match a Weibull distribution to your wind data. This is just one method of doing it. There's lots of different approaches. So we're looking at the histogram that was created before, which we're going to try and overlay a Weibull distribution to this and match it. So if we go back to the original data, we need to have some idea of what the wind power density was of this site. So we're going to calculate that for each time step. 1/2 times rho times velocity in meters per second cubed, and we're going to do that for every time step, copy it down, and we're going to take the average of those values. We see it's 115.3 watts per meter squared, so that's power per unit area of the swept rotor. Now if we go back to our data in our plot, I'm going to create now a column with the Weibull distribution. I'm going to use the built-in Weibull function in Excel, Weibull.dist. It's asking for the velocity, which is going to be our VIN value, and then alpha is the shape factor, which talk about in a second, and then the beta is the lambda, which is our scale factor, and then it's asking if this is a cumulative function or not, and we don't want the cumulative function, so we're going to say false. And now I'm going to fix those shape and scale factors so that they don't change as I copy this down by using the dollar signs. So I can copy this down, and this creates the Weibull curve. I've already got it automatically plotting over here, so you can see it overlaid. I wanted to point out that the average velocity of this data set happened to be 4.5 meters per second, and in order to calculate the lambda, which is a function of the average velocity, it's also a function of the scale factors, and we don't necessarily know that, so we're guessing 2, which is the Rayleigh distribution, as a starting point, but that's really the number that we need to match here. So in order to match it, I'm going to again calculate the wind power density. 1/2 times rho times, again, the bin velocity cubed. And then we also need to multiply this by the Weibull distribution, or the percentage of time which it spends at each of the bins. And then we're going to sum this column instead of average it, because it's already a weighted average. And we get 106.59 watts per meter squared. And just for comparison purposes, I'm going to bring the value from the other page over. It was 115.3 watts per meter squared. So you can just adjust k here, and you can fiddle with it until they match. That's one way of doing it. Or you can use the solver function. And with the solver function, we're going to set the objective cell to be this number, which we want to match this number. The value that we're going to match is this 115.3, and we're going to do it by changing the k value. So it will run through all the iterations. It's found a solution. I'm going to say we want to keep that, and it comes out to be 1.85 for the shape factor. You can see that the plots don't perfectly overlay one another. That's because the original data may not have been a perfect Weibull distribution, but you do have them matched to have similar power density, which is important in terms of wind resource assessment.